I'm going to talk about osmosis. Osmosis is the movement of water molecules from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration across a selective permeable membrane. The other names for selective permeable membranes are partially permeable membrane or semi-permeable membrane. So the movement of water molecules continues until the water molecules are evenly distributed. The other thing that you're supposed to know on osmosis is a water solution. What is a water solution and some types of water solutions. So a water solution is a solution in which water is a solvent. And the amount of concentration of water molecules in a solution is referred to as a water potential. A solution with a high concentration of water molecules is referred to as a diluted solution. And a solution that has low concentration of water molecules is referred to as a concentrated solution. Then we come to the next one, the types of water solutions. We have three types of water solutions. We have hypotonic solution, isotonic solution, and hypertonic solutions. So there are three, hypotonic solution, hypertonic solution, and isotonic solution. So I'll start with the first one. What's a hypotonic solution? So a hypotonic solution is a solution that has a high concentration of water than the cell. It's also referred to as a concentration that has a high water potential and less concentration of solutes. So when the cell is placed in this hypotonic solution, water molecules will move from the solution into the cell. Then I come to the next one. What's a hypertonic solution? A hypertonic solution is a type of solution that has low concentration of water than the cell. It is also referred to as a type of solution that has low concentration of water and high concentration of solids. When a cell is placed in this hypertonic solution, water molecules are moved from the cell into the solution. And lastly, the solution that I'm going to talk about is the isotonic solution. So this type of a solution here, isotonic solution, is a type of solution that has an equal amount of water molecules and equal amount of water molecules to that of the cell and equal amount of solutes to that of a cell. So if a cell is placed in this isotonic solution, nothing happens. There is no change that occurs. The other thing that you're supposed to know on osmosis is the behavior of the plant cell when it is placed in a hypotonic solution. So I need to talk about the behavior of the plant cell if placed in a hypertonic solution. I've said that a hypertonic solution is a solution that has a higher concentration of water than the cell. So So if a cell is placed in this hypotonic solution, you discover that water molecules will move from the solution into the cell. And as more water molecules are moved from the solution into the plant cell, we discover that the plant cell will increase in size and it will swell. And this process is referred to as stagidity. The plant cell does not burst during this process. This is because the plant cell is surrounded by an elastic cell that is made up of strong fibers called cellulose. So the process in which water molecules move from the solution into the cell, and as the cell increases in size, this process is referred to as turgidity. And the process of the turgidity can be drawn as follows. So then I'm drawing a plant cell, a normal plant cell. So as you can see, this is a normal plant cell. Then this normal plant cell, if you place it in a hypotonic solution, you discover that it will gain more. It will gain water. As it gains water, you discover that it will increase in size and it will swell. And this process is referred to as turgidity. So this is the process of turgidity. But the plant cell does not burst during this process because it is made up of an elastic cell that is made up of strong fibers known as cellulose. The other thing that you're supposed to know on osmosis is the behavior of a plant cell if it is placed in a hypertonic solution. So the first one that I've talked about is the behavior of the plant cell when it is placed in a hypotonic solution. But the second one is the behavior of the plant cell if it is placed in a hypertonic solution. So when you place a plant cell in a hypertonic solution, water molecules will move from the cell into the solution. And as more water molecules moves from the cell into the solution, you discover that the cell membrane will detach from the cell. And this process is referred to as plasmolysis. So the process of plasmolysis can be drawn on the chalkboard like this. So this is the process of plasmolysis. So this is a normal plant cell. So the normal plant cell, when it is placed in a hypertonic solution, it's going to lose the water. The water will move into the solution. So as it releases some water molecules, it discovers that the cell membrane, this part, the cell membrane will detach from the cell. And this process is referred to as plasmolysis. Then the other thing that I'm supposed to talk about is the behavior of an animal cell when it is placed in a hypotonic solution. So the behavior of an animal cell when placed in a hypotonic solution. So when you place an animal cell in a hypotonic solution, water molecules will move from the solution into the cell. And as more water moves from the solution to the cell, you discover that the cell begins to increase in size and it will swell. You discover that as more water enters the animal cell, the cell will burst. And this process is referred to as rhesus. The animal cell bursts during this process because it is not surrounded by the serum. So the process of rhesus can be drawn as follows. So this is a normal animal cell. It is placed in hypotonic solution, so it will gain some water molecules that is coming from the solution. So as it gains some water molecules, it discovers that it will increase in size and it will swell. But at the later stage, you discover that it's going fast. This is because the animal cell is not made up of the cell. The other thing that I'm supposed to talk about is the behavior of an animal cell when placed in a hypertonic solution. So when you place an animal cell in a hypertonic solution, you discover that the water molecules will move from the cell into the solution. As more water molecules move from the cell into the solution, you discover that the cell will shrink and cripple. And this process is referred to as cell crenation. So the process of cell crenation can be drawn like this on the chalkboard. I'm going to draw it, the process of cell crenation. this is the diagram that shows self-emission. So there is a normal animal cell over here. So when it is placed in a hypertonic solution, it will lose some water molecules. It will lose some water molecules into the solution. So as it loses some water molecules, we discover that it will reduce in size and the cell will shrink and creep. So this is the diagram that summarizes cell crenation. And this is all about osmosis. Thank you.